Hi everyone, welcome to Kids Church here on Sunday morning. It's our Easter Sunday service. We're really excited with what's going on here. We've got our story that we're going to be looking at. We have a memory verse as well as worship. And I really want to encourage you with the worship. We're going to get up, we're going to learn the dance moves. It's going to be a really good time of fun and I'm really excited. So we're going to head over to worship now. So I just want you to get ready, limber up and join in.
Greatest day in history, death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave, life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive. He's alive. My sin away. Oh, happy day, happy day. I've never been that same. Forever I am changed. When I stand in that place, free and lost, meeting face to face, I am yours, Jesus, you are mine. And this joy, perfect peace, healthy pain finally will cease. Celebrate, Jesus is alive. He's alive.
Sparky.
Hello, Sally.
Oh, I'm having a real problem. I can't read this book that Nick's given me.
Well, Sally, it might be because it's upside down.
What? Turn myself upside down? Yeah, that works. I can see the words. I can see the pictures. They're all up the right way. But, oh, that gives me a funny head, Sparky. That's not going to work.
Well, Sally, maybe we should turn the book the right way up.
What? Oh, that's so much better.
Yes.
But...
Sorry, what is it now?
I can't read, Sparky.
Oh, Sally, that's ridiculous. Why have you got a book if you can't read?
I don't know.
Oh. Who did you say you were waiting for again?
Nick.
Okay. Shall we see if we can find him at all? I'll just pop off and see if I can see him. Maybe you should call him.
I know what we do, boys and girls. Shall we shout for Nick really loudly after three? Ready? One, two, three, Nick!
Did you find him?
No. The boys and girls weren't shouting loud enough. We're going to have to try again. Okay. Louder this time. After three. One, two, three. Nick!
Hi, guys. I'm just coming. I'm running a bit late.
Oh,
there we go.
I think he heard us that time.
Yes. Hi, guys. How are we doing? Hi, hi. Hi. Hi, everyone.
Hi, Nick.
Hi, everyone. Oh, is this the book? Oh, fantastic. Yeah. Thank you for that, Sally. That's really helpful.
I tried to read it, you see, but then I remembered.
Yeah.
I don't know how to read.
Oh, okay. Well, at least you tried. That was, at least, yeah, that's a good try. Well done. Well done. Hi, Sparks. How are you? I'm okay, Nick. Nice to see you. Can I listen to you read the story as well? Mm. Yeah, yeah, you can.
Maybe, Sparky,
you
could sit down there on that nice comfy rug.
Oh, yes. Oh yes, I'll do that. I will do that. I'll go down here. There we go. So, you alright, Sparks? Yeah. Good, that's what I like to see. Right, Sally, I said we would come and read this book, so I'll come a bit closer. And then what we're going to do is we're going to read this book together. And the book is called The Garden, The Curtain and The Cross.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. It's a really good book. And it's
okay.
A true story, did you know?
No, I didn't know.
Yeah, exactly. So, a very long time ago, right here in this world, there was a garden.
Wow.
Do you like gardens?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, great, great. In the garden, everything was wonderful. The world was full of laughing and playing and smiling and fun. There was nothing bad ever. There was nothing sad ever.
No coronavirus,
no locked in. And best of all, do you know what was best of all?
What?
God was there.
Wait.
Waiting.
Wait.
Yeah.
Wait, who's God?
Now, okay, God made the world. He made the world. He made you, he made me, he made everyone. God made everything, every creature, everyone.
Even my smelly brother.
Yes, even your smelly brother.
And my 12 sisters.
Yep, and your 12
I've
sisters.
Got Amanda and Charlotte and Lucy
and
Isabella and Jessica and Emily and I've got lots more.
Fantastic. I don't think we need to hear them all, but it's great that you've got so many sisters. And why don't, after I tell you this story, why don't you go and tell them about it? That might be a really good idea. What do you think?
We'll see.
We'll see. We'll see. Okay. So anyway, God made everything. He made it all. He was in charge of it all and he loved it all.
Wow.
Mm. People could see God and speak to God and just enjoy being with God.
Cool.
It was a wonderful to live with God. But then one day...
What?
The people did a terrible thing. Yeah, terrible thing. They decided they didn't want to do what God said.
I do terrible things.
Do you? What terrible
All
things do you do?
All the time.
What terrible things do you do?
My mum, she tells me off all the time. Because I mean to my sisters.
Are you?
Sometimes I pull their hair.
Oh, that's not good, is it, Sally?
And sometimes I hide their toys.
That's not good either, Sally, is
and
it?
And sometimes I push my brother and I have to sit on a naughty step. Every time, it's so sad.
I know. But you know what? That's not a good thing.
but I'm sure God forgive you for that. And they decide, and the people in this garden, they did something terrible. They did a really terrible thing. Okay. They didn't want to do what God said.
Oh.
They decided they wanted a world without God in charge.
Oh.
The person who made it all, they didn't want him to be in charge.
That now, seems a bit silly.
It does seem a bit silly, doesn't it? Now, God calls this sin.
Sin? I love to sing.
Not sing.
I'm going to sing you a song now.
Not sing, sin.
La la
sin.
La 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 la. La 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 la. My mum says I'm the best singer in the world. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. What is it?
Hi. Not sing. Sin.
What on earth is sin?
Wow. Well, let me tell you. Sin is not doing what God said. It's not listening to God and doing what we're told to by God. That is sin.
Not la.
No, that's sing. We don't want to sing. We don't want to sin.
Oh.
Singing is good. Sin is bad.
Okay.
Yeah? Okay. Sin spoils things. So sin has no place in God's wonderful garden. God said to the people, "You can't live with me in my garden anymore." And he sent them outside. All right, outside the garden.
Nick, guess what?
What?
I've been sent outside before.
Outside of where?
At school!
Okay.
It was Mr. Richards! He caught me messing around in my science lesson!
Oh, did
he? We had the Bunsen burners out!
Yeah.
And then I was partners with Cindy Lou! And then all of a sudden one of her little pigtails got caught in the Bunsen burner and she went up in flames! Oh, it was a terrible day. And now, Cindy Lou used to be my best friend and now her mum says that she can't be my friend anymore!
It's okay. It's okay, Sal.
And then I got sent outside and Mr. Richards was so mean!
Why was he mean?
Because he sent me outside!
Oh, okay. But it's okay. It's okay. It does seem quite an extreme thing to happen. And yeah. It's probably quite dangerous and painful.
All these things seem to always happen to me. I'm always in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Okay. Well, it's okay. It's okay. But this is what happened in the story. God sent them outside the garden.
Oh.
Mm. And to show people that they had to stay outside, unlike you, God put warrior angels in front of the garden.
Wow, that would be scary.
That would be very scary. The angels were like a big keep out sign.
Oh.
Mm, they were. Now, things were sometimes bad and people were sometimes sad.
Yeah.
Yeah. But people still kept on sinning because they didn't...
Sinning.
People... No! Sally, control yourself! Sally, control yourself. People still kept on sinning because they didn't want God to be in charge.
Oh.
So no one could come into God's wonderful place.
Oh, that's sad.
That is sad. God said, because of your sin, you can't come in.
Sin. Oh, sin, not sin.
Sin. Because of your sin, you can't come in.
The bad things.
Yeah, that's it. Bad things. God wanted people to remember, it is wonderful to live with him, but because of your sin, you can't come in.
Oh.
So he told the people to build a special building. God called a building called his temple, where he would live.
Oh.
God would live there.
Wow.
Yeah. In the middle of the temple was the most wonderful place in the world. Where do you think, who do you think was in the middle? What do you think was in the middle?
I know.
What's the most wonderful place you can think of? What is it?
It's the zoo! I went to the zoo with my mum, my dad, my 12 sisters and my brother.
Right.
And we saw the lions and the tigers and the chimpanzees. They were swinging in the trees. And even a walrus.
A walrus. What's so special about the walrus?
Well, he's got massive tusks, you see.
Great. Fantastic. Do you like the walrus?
Uh-huh.
Okay, well, we're getting a bit distracted. We should probably get back to this. But the most wonderful place in the middle of the temple was not the zoo!
Huh?
It was not the zoo. It's not the most wonderful place. The place where God was is the most wonderful place. And that...
Wow.
Yeah, and that was in the middle of the temple.
That sounds exciting.
That is. That place, there was nothing bad and no one sad.
Why?
It was very exciting. Did you know that?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Fantastic. But then God told the people to put a big curtain around this wonderful place.
Oh.
Big curtain, yeah. The curtain had pictures of warrior angels on it.
Wow.
It was a big keep out sign.
Just like got the garden?
Yeah, just like the garden, yeah, that's right. For hundreds of years, the temple curtain reminded people that God said it is wonderful to live with him, but because of your sin, you can't come in.
Oh, no, because of the bad stuff.
All the bad stuff, yeah, that's right.
Oh.
So babies became grown-ups and had babies, and those babies, and those grown-ups had babies, and those babies became grown-ups and had babies, and those babies became grown-ups and had babies.
Lots of babies.
Yeah, lots of babies. And hundreds of summers and winters passed by, and the keep-out curtain stayed in the temple.
Wow.
Mm. Then one day, God's son came to live in the world as a person.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
Are you trying to tell me that God has a son?
Yeah, God has a son, Sally. And his name is Jesus.
Oh, I know Jesus.
Oh, yeah?
They talk about him at Christmas time.
Yeah, that's it. That's the one.
You know that song about Jesus at Christmas? We always sing.
Yes, that one.
Well, maybe I could start it.
No!
Oh.
No singing!
Okay.
Later. Mm-hmm. To your sisters, maybe.
Oh, okay, we love singing together.
Oh, good, that's fine, but...
Make a lot of noise.
Yes, but later.
Okay.
Okay, later, that's a great thing, later. So... Then one day, God's son came to live with us in this world as a person. And he was called Jesus. Yes, well done, very good. Jesus.
Baby Jesus.
No, just Jesus, because Jesus did grow up.
Huh?
Yep. So Jesus always did what God said, and Jesus never sinned.
No way.
Yeah, he never did anything wrong.
That's
amazing. I know, he was...
I'm always getting in trouble every day.
Yes, I'm sure you are, Sally. But you know what? Jesus didn't. He never sinned.
Amazing.
And Jesus visited the temple where the keep-out curtain hung. Jesus knew that things were sometimes bad and sometimes sad. Jesus did what God had sent him. So Jesus said that God had sent him to open the way back to God's wonderful place where there would be nothing bad and no one sad.
No one sad at all.
But people still didn't want to let God in charge.
Why?
No. Well, they didn't want to let God in charge. They didn't want to do what God said. So they decided to put Jesus on the cross to die.
Yeah. That's so sad, Nick.
Oh, I know.
He hadn't done anything wrong.
No, he never did anything wrong.
He never sinned.
No.
And they put him on a cross to die. That must have really hurt.
Well, he died. Hurt a lot and then he died. Oh no, it was sad. It was the most bad thing that had ever happened. It was the most sad thing of all time. But Jesus had a plan.
Well,
he always had planned to die on the cross.
Huh?
Yeah. What a strange plan. Why would God's son plan to die on the cross?
I don't know.
On the cross, Jesus took all our sin. Not sing, sin. Jesus took all our sin, all the bad things we do and all the sad things they cause. Jesus took them all from us.
Wow.
And when he did it, something amazing, astonishing happened.
What was it, Nick?
The curtain tore.
No way.
God ripped up the keep out sign. God's wonderful place is open again. Because Jesus died, we can now go in.
Wow.
Into God's wonderful place.
Even
you, with all the bad things you might have done, Jesus has taken that punishment from you and he's set you free from it.
That's amazing.
I know.
Oh my goodness.
I know, it's pretty amazing, isn't it? So the story carries on and it says after Jesus died, his friends put him in a tomb.
What's a tomb?
Tomb. Tomb's like a cave.
A cake?
Well, no.
I love cakes.
Yesterday,
my mum, she made a cake that had chocolate buttons all over it.
It's Easter time soon.
She put these little eggs on top. And you know what I did, boys and girls? I was a bit naughty.
What did you do?
And I ate all the cake up. I put it in here. I told you I was sometimes naughty.
Yes. Not a cake. It's like a cave.
Oh.
No, a big dark hole.
Like where my mum's cake went.
No. It's darker hole. It's where they put people. It's like a hole in it's a tomb. Just say it's a tomb. It's a tomb. Okay, it's a tomb. And they were very sad. For 2 days nothing happened. Then the next morning, Jesus' friends went to see his body in the tomb.
Oh. That's weird.
And it wasn't there.
What?
No.
But where was it?
Well,
had it gone like my cake? Because my cake goes in my tomb, and then it disappears,
No, it doesn't. No.
Oh.
We don't need to say this, do we? We don't need to tell you what cake turns into after you've eaten it. You don't need to say it.
Okay.
Right. Thank you for that, Sally. Much better. So anyway, his body wasn't there. A little later on, Jesus' friends were all together and suddenly Jesus was there alive.
Wait a minute, how is he alive again? You told me that he died 3 days ago, Nick.
Well, let's put it like this, his friends weren't sad anymore. Now they were so, so happy. God had brought Jesus back to life so that he could live in God's wonderful place forever.
Incredible. God must be so powerful.
God is
and
powerful.
So clever.
And Jesus is God.
Wow.
That's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, Nick. It is.
And Jesus has sent everyone an invitation to come and live with him there too.
Wait, I'm going to go see if I've got one.
Whoa. Sally?
I haven't got an invitation. I just looked at my letterbox and there was nothing there.
Yes, but he sent an invitation through the story of what you listened to.
So the postman doesn't deliver it through my letterbox?
No.
Oh.
He invites everyone to it. And when they hear this story of the gospel, they can choose whether to accept that invitation or not.
Oh.
Yeah. So, God says it is wonderful to live with him, but because of your sin you can't come in. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I do.
But Jesus said, but I died on the cross to take your sin, so all my friends can now come in. Do you want to be one of his friends?
I really do, Nick. How do I do it?
Well, we'll look at this in a minute at the book, in the book. We'll just carry on the book and at the end it tells you how we can do that.
I'm really excited.
So we can live with God forever. There will be nothing bad and no one sad.
That's amazing.
We will see God and speak to God and just enjoy being with God just as he had always planned. It will be wonderful to live with him, and it's all because of Jesus.
Wow.
We will say every day, thank you, Jesus, you're amazing. And we can start saying that today. Did you know that?
I'm going to say it now. Thank you, Jesus, you're amazing.
Yeah, and we can be Jesus' friend today. All we need to do is pray and ask him.
Right now.
Right now.
I can be Jesus' friend.
You can be Jesus' friend and accept that invitation. And what you've got to do is you've just got to shut your eyes. Can you shut your eyes?
No.
Okay, well, maybe not shut your eyes, but we can pray. We can pray, which is where we're going to talk to Jesus. We're going to talk to Jesus. We say, Dear Lord.
Dear Lord.
We thank you for your sacrifice of Jesus on the cross.
Thank you that Jesus died for me on the cross.
That's right. And Lord, we want Jesus in our lives.
And I want Jesus in my life.
Amen.
And my heart.
Yeah, that's lovely. Amen. That's a really lovely prayer. Amen. Well done, Sally. So now...
What now, Nick?
You're in the family. You're one of his friends.
I'm a friend of Jesus?
You're a friend of Jesus
but
right now.
Is that just for me, then and no one else?
No, that's for everyone who does that prayer, who asks Jesus to be in their life.
Even all the boys and girls watching this?
Yes, all the boys and girls who are watching this, even them, they accept Jesus in their life and they're friends with him too.
Did you hear that, boys and girls? You too could have Jesus as your friend.
You can.
Yeah. If you want to pray that prayer, maybe you could go and speak to your grown-up.
Yeah.
And I'm sure they'd be excited to tell you all about it.
Yeah, I'm sure they will be. Isn't that cool? So, you're now a friend of Jesus, and Jesus has forgiven you for all the bad things you've done wrong.
Wow, even the cake and the Bunsen burner. And all of the things I haven't told you about yet.
Yes, exactly. And you don't need to tell me about them because Jesus has forgiven you from them. It's okay, you don't
need to... I'll go and say sorry to Jesus, shall I?
Yeah, exactly that. That's exactly right. And you know what? Why don't you go and tell this story to all your family as well? If you're really excited about it, wouldn't it be a great idea to go and take this book and go and tell everyone?
What a great idea, Nick.
There we go.
And I'll get my big sister, Isabella, to read it to me.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Because I can't read.
Okay. Right, why don't you should run off now, Sally. And we'll see you later.
Book.
Yeah, okay, good idea.
Oh, bye, boys and girls.
Bye, Sally. Sally Sparky, what do you think?
I think it was really good. I enjoyed that story.
Why don't you go with Sally and see if you can tell her family as well?
That's a great idea. Wait a minute, Sally, I'm coming.
I've got something to tell you, Sparky. Come on.
I'm coming. Let's go.
Bye, boys and girls. So we just looked at the story with Sally. I read the book, really enjoyed it. Great to see that she wants to be Jesus' friend as well. But there's something I really want to make really clear, is that Jesus died to take away our sin. And I think that's so important. That is everything. Jesus died for you. Jesus died for me to take away all the things I've done wrong, all the things you've done wrong. And he wants you to know that he wants you. He wants to be with you. He wants to spend the rest of eternity with you. He wants to be forever with you, which is really exciting. But really want to say this, Jesus loves you. And if you want to know Jesus and be his friend, I really want to tell you to go and speak to an adult in your house. Okay, guys?
Do a diddy diddy dum diddy do. Hey, this is my singing practice. What are you doing here, Sparky?
I'm the backing vocals.
Okay, we'll sing quietly over there. Do a diddy diddy dum diddy do. Do a diddy diddy dum diddy do. Oh wait, I think I know a memory verse. That's to the tune of that.
Oh, what's that then?
It from Nick.
That's really good.
Yeah, Nick's quite a good singer, actually.
No, he's not.
Oh. Well, anyway.
Okay.
It's that same tune, Sparky. You could use my mic if I would share it. And I'll eat it! And it goes... How's it go again? Jesus gave his life for us. 1 John 3 verse 16. Do you want to try that?
Okay.
Well, do you want to do the backing vocals and I'll do the main thing?
Okay.
I'd better have all the shop then. I'll go at the front and you just go at the back. Ready? Jesus gave his life for us. 1 John 3 verse 16. Try it again because you messed it up, Sparky.
Okay.
Jesus gave his life for us. 1 John 3 verse 16. Oh, that'll be good enough, Sparky.
Oh, okay. Well,
bye.
Bye, everybody.
Bye, boys and girls. Hope you know your memory verse.
So I thought it'd be good to finish with a prayer, guys. So what I would like us to do is just bow our heads or shut our eyes, and I'm going to say a prayer and you can join in. Yeah, dear Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you for the fact we get to worship you and spend time learning about you on a Sunday, and especially on this Easter Sunday, when you came back to life, when you rose again from the grave. And Lord, you brought us with you. So I thank you for that. I thank you that you died on the cross for all that are our sin. And Lord, I pray that you just be in this place right now. I pray you be in our country, in our towns, and be with us in our homes. And help us love you and trust you more. Amen.
What's a tomb?
It's like a cave. It's like
a cave?
No, not a cave. Careful of the camera. Sally's going to say she can't read and what she's going to do, and then you're going to have to come in and turn the book over, you know, like that. So that's what's going to happen. Now, Sally, did you get that? You're going to say you can't read.
But it was just a trick. I didn't have my glasses.
Can you read now?
Where's everything gone? I can't see anything.
Why don't you go with Sally and tell her family about Jesus?
Oh yes, Sparky, come with me. I've got something really exciting to tell you about Jesus.
Okay.
Upside down.
Oh, it's upside down. Yeah. Should I turn the book over for you?